Hello everyone, today we are solving day 7 of a band of code. Let's see if I can do better this time. I'll start timer as usual. Let's see if the REPL is working. The REPL seems to be working. Okay, let's go and read the task. Okay, some of its parts. The instruction specifies a series of steps and requirements about each steps must be finished before others can begin your parallel input. Each step is designated by a single letter. For example, suppose you have the following instruction: step C must be finished before step A. Blah blah blah. Visually, these requirements look like this. Okay, your first goal is to determine the order in which the step should be completed. If more than one step is ready, choose the step which is first alphabetically. In this example, two steps will be completed as follows. Only C is available, and so it is done first. Next, both A and F are available. A is first alphabetically, so it is done next. Then, even though F was available earlier, steps B and D are now also available, and B is the first alphabetically. Number 3, blah, blah, blah. So in this example, the correct order is C, A, B, F, D, E. What order should step instruction be completed? Okay, it seems to be an easy, like, topological sort or something like that, right? So let's put it here. We need lines, and we also need to parse line, right? So basically line looks like this. Let's column them before and after. B is before and after is basically it's going to look like this. This needs to be escaped. Here we have letter, right? And here we have letter as well. So it will look like this. Right, so this basically, so we must return something before, after, something like that. Okay, let's see that it actually works. Oops. Collision error, and it's not supporting. Matches regex. Now it works. So from B to X. Okay, perfect. So basically, what we need is a map from step to its requirements, right? So basically, basically we need group by, but group by doesn't do the right thing, entirely right thing, right? So, okay, four lines before, after is parse line L. I guess here we need to do that. So what I am going after, so basically this will create, and now we need to group by. Basically, group by is the same as reduce, I guess. Okay, let's just do reduce. So why do we need like right lines, like lines, there's a map and map and L, right line. So basically, before after will be basically parse line L, right? Then we need to assort to M as a key would be after. So and the value will be M after or empty set, sorted set. I'm after a sorted set, and basically condition after like that. Okay, so here we see that T requires this much, Q requires this much, and so on. They're all sorted, and there must be one which has no no requirements, right? But now I'm thinking that there will be none, right? So basically, how do we figure out the step which we can start? So let's call it this requirements, like Rex, right? So this will be Rex. Okay, so this like list of steps that are required to complete something, but there are no steps that require nothing, because like they just wouldn't be in there. So basically what we need to do is to make a set of all possible steps. So for example, basically map lines. Okay, I need to parse line lines, parsed lines, map parse line lines. I really need this. Okay. Like this. So basically map before after. So basically we need first first lines, it's like that. Then we need to turn it into set. Right, so this basically inputs, right? Now let's see how many inputs we have. 25. Okay. What if we what if I can cut, like, let's have everything steps, like all possible steps. Right, so basically like that. So yeah, the 26 set of steps. Okay, I could guess it, but it's better to know exactly. So 26 steps. So basically, possible inputs are the ones that are here, but not in requirements, right? So basically, if we set difference steps and keys Rex. So those ones are K, B, and V, like B. B, right? So step B never appears on the right, step key never appears on the right. Yeah, okay, cool. So basically, yeah, this is what we start with, and we need to write something like a loop, right? So basically, I have no idea what to start with. Let's start with a loop, right? So basically, requirements will be requirements. List of steps will be like still list of steps. Okay, so basically, we need the result. So result is just like we need a string, right? So what do we need? Yeah, we need a string. Okay, so let's have string here. I don't know. okay, so basically, what do we need to do? So basically, open exactly this, right? So basically, the different steps and keys requirements. Next is to do is, well, basically, go with, okay, first sort open, right? So the first sort open is the one that we will go with, and there we need to remove it. So basically we are completing the step basically, and we need to remove it from all the values of from requirements, right? So basically requirements will be into this map for whiles in current requirements. Okay, disjoin whiles goes something like that, and we recur on okay, yeah, when also yeah, also when. Okay, so rest will be set. Complete. Okay. So if the only requirements for step is go with, we will not include it at all. Right, so basically we need to this conch completed go with and strs go with, and we need exit condition, right? So if this is empty, we just return s. Okay, let's hope. Oh yeah, sorry, but we cannot go into completed, already completed, right? So we need to remove this difference except one or any number of sets called. So we need to remove completed from it as well. Right? So let's see if we get something. Cool, we get something. Okay, cool. But I can't copy it. No, I know how to copy it, so you have to go to output and copy it from here. Let's see if it's correct. That's not the right answer. If you're stuck, there's Okay, let's see. If this is correct. Well, it lacks one letter, right? So we are missing one letter somehow here. Why? We don't have repeated ones, as far as I can tell, right? So let's actually try this on this, right? So basically, that way we will know what we are missing, right? So lines, parsed lines, rex, steps, and let's see what C A B D F. Yeah, yeah, and we're missing the last one. Why we are missing the last one? I don't understand. Let's return res and rex. Complete. So requirements is empty, completed is not. What are our requirements? A requires C, F requires C, E requires B, F. Right, so if at some point uh, Yes, algorithm is not entirely correct. So I removed something that I shouldn't have removed. So the mistake is like here, right? So we cannot. Cannot move. So basically, okay, let's do it differently, right? So requirements will be merge. Okay, steps go here. We'll have to merge four S steps, like S and empty, right? And this, well, let's see. So now we have okay. Now we have the C step, which requires no input at all, right? Okay, cool. With that in mind, and without doing this one, and without doing like steps, we remove completed, and we also instead of this, we have to like take rex filter fn. Second, no, oh no, well, basically I have to actually take this, all these steps, and remove completely from. Yeah. But I need to interrupt the calculation. This one. I guess there's one letter A, B, C. I could have guessed it, but. Oh my God. Relation cannot find all reasons. Okay, it's spinning again, so I guess I'm doing something incorrectly. Actually, I can even skip this part and like only leave this one and just this way I won't need to complete it at all. And this. And let's move it to part one. I still don't understand why is it stuck, but this should work, right? So let's see what relating the file will give us. Like, do we still have rex? Alright, we still have them. And actually, input is small, right? So our input is currently really small, and for some reason, it's not calculating it. Why? Okay, let's see. This one we don't need. So open all pairs, right? Which have empty requirements. Not the first one. Yeah, okay, so it works. Okay, perfect. So let's just we evaluate everything. Steps should be bigger now, and part one should be. So the last letter that was the letter that was missed was N. Right, let me just sanity check this. 26, yeah, 26. Okay, this is the first answer. Let me mark my time. My time, 20 minutes. Wow, that's still a lot. Okay, yeah. Okay, let's go read this second part. This is about the intersection of holes. Now you need to account for multiple people working on steps simultaneously. If multiple people are available, workers should still begin them in alphabetical order. Each step takes 60 seconds plus a mile corresponding to its letter A, 1, B, 2, C, 3, and so on. So step A takes 61 seconds, while step Z takes 86 seconds. No time is required between steps. To simplify things, for the example, however, suppose you only have to help from one of a total of two workers, and that each step takes 60 fewer seconds. So that then, using the same instructions as above, this is how each second would be spent. Second one, worker one works on C. Second three. Okay, I think I. Okay, yeah. Well, each row represents 1 second of time. The second column identifies how many seconds have passed as of the beginning of that second. Each worker column shows the step that worker is currently doing, or dot is the idle. The second column shows complete steps. Note that the order of steps has changed. This is because steps now take time to finish, and multiple workers can begin multiple steps simultaneously. In this example, it will take 15 seconds for two workers to complete the steps, with five workers and 60 plus seconds. Step durations described above, how long will it take to complete all of the steps? Oh, now it is interesting. Now it is interesting. Okay. Okay, let's do the parts. Let's calculate duration, right? So basically it would be int first step minus int a plus minus int a and plus 61 actually. Perfect. Okay, so duration, we know duration. Okay. Now it's actually kind of the same, right? So it's kind of the same, but but it's tricky. yeah, so we have to emulate this work distribution and stuff. Or we can emulate. We can actually probably emulate the seconds, right? So we can go. So this actually suggests one idea for the solution, where you basically just emulate each second, right? So second zero, like your advanced step or something. Yeah. Okay. So basically, if we take this. So if we have empty worker and available task, we pick that task. If we don't have empty worker, we advance the step, right? So basically, let's say that Q is, so the complete order is like when it's complete, right? So basically, Q will be like a map of later to time. Step to time, and time is 0 seconds, right? So, and okay, now we have like we have a couple of conditions, right? So a couple of things could happen, and the first and simplest one is Q is less than. So the first step is we have to assign works probably. So if or we can identify like end condition or something like that. So as long as let's check something. Let's check. Okay, let's try finish. Okay, so we send Q here, and basically it will for step time Q when time is zero. We can stop, right? So if some done, if some step is done, which is try finish here, right? We recall these on the same requirements, Rex. Master res done. This soak Q done. And same time. Okay, cool. So this is the simplest one, right? So if we can finish something, we finish, right? Now, if we have workers, right? If we have workers. Okay, let's actually, if we don't have workers, right? Let's say we don't have workers. So count Q is bigger equal than 5 workers. So all 5 workers are working on something. So the only thing we can do is actually just continue doing this, right? So requirements don't change, result don't change. Basically time, increment time once. And we need to defin work, basically, right? So the work is really simple, and it is, I should return only the first one here. Okay. This will be basically into the map step time. Basically, step back time. Right. So 1 second of this of each work. Right. So work here. If two elves finish simultaneously, I wonder what happened. I guess the one that let's make it sorted map, just in case. Right. So like that. Let's see if it compiles. Okay, so if we have full queue, okay, now the queue is not full, so we have one more elf, right? So it means try take. And actually, we will want the requirements, right? So basically, first sort first. Right? So, so basically, we take requirements, we filter the ones that are ready to be picked up, basically, right? We sort them and return the first one. If we can take something, if some next, let's call it next, but let's call it go with because I already used it name, right? So try take Rex. If we can take work and there is an empty elf, right? So basically, what we do here is we recur with requirements. If we take work, no, we desocket from requirements, so nobody else. Right, the rest we don't touch that. The queue, we actually assert queue with duration. Actually, let's call it step. We don't change that, right? If we can take work, right? We'll do that. If workers are free, but there are no work to take, we basically recur with we just work, right? And now the only thing left is finish condition, right? So finish condition, if we have empty requirements and also empty work, right? If you have that, we return us. Otherwise, okay. Would it work? I don't know. No idea, actually. Let's just print len time and kill each step. Okay. There's also a kill. Okay. Try take. Okay. See. Another pass to a sock. Okay, where is the sock? A sock queue step. Yes. Now let's go look at the output. No output here. No. I guess it's an infinite loop for them. Right. There it is. Okay, it's a shame. Okay, let's just restart the terminal as we usually do, and let's actually let's try to do the same but in REPL. This part is correct. Yeah. Now, when REPL is here, I just want to see what the hiccup is. Right. So we are using. Let's use a smaller input. Yeah. It reloads. Okay, so time just grows indefinitely, right? And I'm not sure if I can scroll to the beginning of this. Okay, I actually can. Okay, so we have zero work now. Then we have C, right? The C is 63 and goes down, so one elf works on C, right? It's finished and it is removed correctly. Now, other elf. Yeah, I know. So when at the point when try finish, yeah, here try finish, right? So we have to actually update everything in requirements here, like I did here. Let's call it remove from requirements. Basically, we just go over each requirement. I just killed the terminal, I guess. That's not what I was planning to do. Okay, now I have still have goalies somewhere. Yes. Oh, yeah, I didn't see. Okay. For next. Okay, so we have like something, and actually, let's. So the time is 14, right? And we have to. Add 1 second, I want more second. So I guess it gets into complete. So basically, we have to add one. Okay, we have to add one. This is fine. This should be fine. Totally fine. The important thing is it works, right? So let's see if we can run part. So it's basically. Oh, because I forgot to return this. Yes. Yes, so 1049. But we have to wait 40 seconds. Okay, so basically the way it works, if you want it to return actual time, and it returns this, right? So basically, yeah, basically this. I think this would be a nice addition, I think. Time 41. Okay, let's see if we can. My answer is too high. Okay, now it is interesting. Now it is interesting. Maybe I didn't understand something about like passing things. So see, like on second two, it actually completes it, but it's not in the done queue yet. For some reason, I don't know why. Right. The next second it is. Okay, let's try to submit 1040. Do we have at any point more than one elf working? Yeah, we have two, right? We have three here. We have four here. Okay, yeah, so it seems to be working. Right. So they seem to parallel the work at least. Okay, so start with B. The ground again. Ah, so the 1040 now is the right answer. Okay, so I guess I don't understand something about this. Let's mark the timestamp on this, so it's 40 minutes, sorry. And actually, I guess there is not much to clean up, really. Alright, it's all nicely put, so Rex is requirements. Let's call it this. Do we use this? Yeah. Initial requirements, right? Steps. Steps again is only used here. So we can actually do this. Right. Parsed lines. Okay, so parsed lines. Well, parsed lines are okay, I guess. But it's okay. So this small is okay, I hope. Maybe it needs some documentation a little bit. Like what it turns. So here, step map to requirements. Right. Support one areas is empty. So it's pretty self-explanatory. So this one. Is actually tritake. So basically these two functions are also used here, so let's move them. This one is step is tritake rex, right, and rex is from Rex. Not just remove from Rex. It's also what was this about? Remove from Rex is removing from requirements. Yeah. I guess it's like this. Yeah, it still works. Okay, cool. So on this one's I think let's comment a little bit, right? So basically find a step that has empty rex, right? And remove from rex is basically remove step from all rex of all the steps. Right, support one, duration is self-explanatory. Did any of the elf finished? If yes, step. And work basically once time in queue by 1 sec. Right, and we need to explain time to complete. So basically, it's this. Right, time is time, address is, yeah, it seems okay. I think it's good to be uploaded. Let's send it, and this is it, I think. See you next time. Bye bye.